And I too will be supporting this budget, and maybe for very different reasons, because I have a different view of how Pennsylvania should go forward. See, I believe the gentleman prior has learned the wrong lesson of the Great Recession. From the Great Recession, what we learned was anemic growth. The inability to stimulate our economy and to put people back to work is what resulted in almost a decade of lagging economic growth. See, what the federal government has done well, in actually two administrations, a Republican and a Democrat, is push stimulus out in unparalleled numbers, PPP loans, direct stimulus, and programs to keep working people going, including enhancements of unemployment compensation. See, they understood putting dollars in the hands of working people stimulates this economy, not putting it in the bank. See, what we need to do is have people be able to come out of this recession stronger. And yes, we have big challenges here in Pennsylvania. I understand that we have demographic challenges in Pennsylvania. They are large. We're an older population. If we're being honest, we're about to lose another congressperson. Do you know why? Because we're not attracting enough young people. We need to figure out how to grow this economy. And I would argue that the fiscal fetal position that those who advocate for this budget, like the gentleman prior, who are scared to embrace an ideology of growth, who talk a lot about tax cuts, but when the opportunity is presented with them to make investments in schools, to say that we're going to create a generation of young learners in Pennsylvania who want to learn in Pennsylvania, who want to stay in Pennsylvania, who want to build businesses in Pennsylvania and jobs, we need to talk about a tax policy, an education policy, yes, a growth policy. For too long, Republicans have made the talk of growth their domain. Well, no longer. With this budget and what they advocate today, an unwillingness to embrace with any confidence an idea of how this economy should go forward. See, we need to attack structural inequities and challenges that are replete in our economy. We have a tax policy that does not encourage growth. We have schools that in too many of our cities do not educate our kids. We have too many cities that do not have economic growth because their property taxes are too high and their schools are stigmatized as inferior. Yes, and that's not just our cities. We have too many rural areas that are hemorrhaging population. And yes, we have too many low-wage workers in Pennsylvania, rural and city, that are underpaid. And we say, when it serves our purpose, that they're essential workers and they should go back to work. But when the time comes to raise the wage, where are they? I would say crickets. My Republican friends have put forth the rhetoric that they're so confident. But what they tell you today is, we need to batten down the hatches because recession comes. Well, those who are optimistic about Pennsylvania's future, who say we can grow our way out of this, see, they talk about dynamic scoring when it serves their purpose of tax cuts for the rich and big corporations, but when it talks about school tax cuts and it talks about investing in education, they are nowhere to be found. They are scared. They will not embrace their own ideology. Pennsylvania needs to start looking for a new direction, and we need that coming from this legislature, because let's be honest, they have never come up with a plan to rebuild broadband, infrastructure, roads and bridges. Their new plan is, we'll talk bad about Uncle Joe, but when his dollars come to Pennsylvania, we'll bank them with glee.
I'm going to suspend. Respectfully, a Republican member was admonished yesterday for referring to the president by name, according to Mason's manual and the rules of the chamber. We will refer to other members of the executive and other branches of the government that we engage with by their official titles, and not in a despairing way, nor will we disparage the members or their comments either. Please do your best to contain your comments to final passage of 255.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, for that admonishment. I want you to know I in no way besmirch the President of the United States, the legitimately elected President of the United States. I respect him. I honor him. And I thank him for the dollars that he have brought to Pennsylvania. Now, For months, we've talked about inequality in Pennsylvania, and we've talked about essential workers. This budget does some very good things, and I applaud those Democrats who've been talking about level up, and I especially recognize those who've been talking about fair funding. Not about stealing from Peter to pay Paul, but talking about making real investments in Reading and Allentown and Hazleton and so many cities across Pennsylvania. See, they've got no answer for that. Crickets is what we've heard. They have no plan to reinvest in those children or those communities or tax bases that have been hollowed out. See, they talk a good game for the business community, but they don't have the courage to come forward and say, how are you actually going to invest in these communities when the taxes are too high, the schools are stigmatized, and the population is hemorrhaging out? Now, this budget, because of Level Up, starts to change the direction. And God willing, with a court system that will hear litigation that is in front of them now, they will recognize that we are not living up to our constitutional obligation to provide a fair and efficient education to every citizen in Pennsylvania. But until the courts hear that challenge, this budget proves one thing. We have a funding formula. We agreed to that in a bipartisan way. And now, today, for the first time, we're going to actually put dollars behind it. But here's the challenge with this budget, and I know my own caucus is divided. 100 of the poorest schools, but we recognize there's almost 300 that are underfunded. What do we tell School District 101? Your kids were just underfunded a little too little. See, this legislature doesn't say, it doesn't have a clue for what to do for the 101 least supported school in Pennsylvania. No, it doesn't have a plan for them, just like it doesn't have a plan to rebuild urban Pennsylvania or stop the hemorrhage of population in rural Pennsylvania. And you know what? As a suburbanite who relies on SEPTA and public education and a growing, prosperous research and development economy, you've got no solution for investments in those businesses because you can't do anything but get in the fetal position and just hope a recession doesn't come. We need a population and a policy in Pennsylvania that says, we're going to grow. We're going to support our friends in the pharmaceutical industry who just brought us an historic vaccine, which some of you may even get. Yes, see, we could be a research and development, an education commonwealth, one that brings high-wage, high-skilled employees to Pennsylvania. Or we can do as the gentleman prior suggested, the fetal position. No investment, no stimulus, no plan for broadband in Greene County, no way to connect our kids to the internet during a pandemic, no real idea on how to move Pennsylvania forward. Yes, grievance is the politics of the day for some. That is all they know. But policy, smart, thoughtful public policy, is what is needed. This budget has some of that. But I would be lying if I didn't tell you there is too much being left on the sidelines, too many kids that aren't being put into the game, too many communities that are being left behind. No, in balance, I know some will come out in favor of this budget and some will come out on the other side. There are those who will say the lack of a minimum wage is a bridge they cannot cross, and I respect that, and my heart is there with them as well. There are those that say $100 million is a good start, and that's enough to get them there, because what it means for Wilkes-Barre and Reading and Hazleton and Johnstown is enough. But for some, in some of those districts, maybe that 101st least funded district, it's just too heartbreaking to bear that somehow they weren't poor enough to get Level Up funding. See, this budget is a tale of two stories. It's good for some, yes, and it leaves behind too many. Now, I don't blame anyone for how they vote on this. I understand that is the challenge before us. But I ask you this. Think about what this budget means for your community. Make that decision based on the policy. Think about what a better Pennsylvania that would embrace Republican, the old Republican orthodoxy of Reagan, an optimistic view of what America could be. Not about grievance, but about growth. Think about what that could mean again for Pennsylvania. Again, I'll be voting yes, but with a recognition that there's so much work to be done.